love it, so we're sharing it with you.
Thank you. first, you know, popularized and you know, well-written, essentially, blues that we know of. In fact, it dates back to melody, supposedly, to 1896 or so. So it still has a lot of different elements that are put together into one song. So for the next number, I'm actually going to try to take apart some of these elements and play sort of an even more improvisatory song. So this will be kind of an original tune that probably won't be played again the same way.
Thank you.
has similar melodies and motifs actually in some ways to Summertime and the first piece I played, the beginning section. So I've been trying to kind of keep certain themes the same while changing other parts, like the style from more or less improvisatory, more or less classically based. So I have both a classical background and a, I play mostly by ear, so I don't really, my stuff usually ends up sounding pretty different if it was just written on the same page. But I still like to pay tribute to the lessons that I learned and the styles that I originally, that I couldn't have developed without doing classical as well. So I'm gonna do one more tune for you that's also going to be somewhat improvisatory, but a little bit closer to
probably the most famous one is the Gollywog's Cakewalk. You've probably heard that one. He wrote these for his three-year-old daughter, Lodema, and she sadly died of diphtheria at the age of 18, but this was written when she was three, so.
Chopin wrote two sets of etudes back in about 1830. And each one was meant to tackle a particular technical aspect of playing that pianists have trouble with. The second set, the Opus 25, is what I'm going to visit today. It's a bit of an outlier as far as the etudes go. This one is not as technically demanding, but it was designed to be a little more musically demanding on the player. It's essentially a trio for cello, viola, and violin, with no cello, viola, or violin. So it's helpful to think of the instrumentation when playing for what it's not. Thank you. same vein, by a contemporary of Chopin named Franz Liszt. A lot of people might recognize the name. He wrote a set of 12 etudes that were not as homogeneous. They were a lot more like tone poems than etudes themselves. This one in particular is probably the most like a tone poem. It's very idiomatic for the piano, lots of different sections, very expansive in the use of the keyboard. Beautiful piece of music. Thank you.
Thank you.